This is Open Broadcaster. We're running, I'm running this on a 27-inch Mac, so you get a wider view of what the program looks like. I'm running it on Chrome. This is the welcome page to Open Broadcaster, where you log in to create a new account. It's easy enough to do. Put your name, your username, your email. Hit the button here, and you get an email with a password that you can change and go into your account, and I'll show you that in a moment. So I am an administrator here. We're running the Open Broadcaster instance at CJUC Radio in Whitehorse, Yukon. So I'll show you how we run our radio station. And log in here, again, as an administrator. This is the real estate workspace that we have here. Again, it's a large screen, so I have lots of space to show you all our features here. Our media library shows here. We have over 81,000 pieces of media, and again, the media is audio, video, and pictures. We have a playlist tab, and on our particular radio station, we have over 781 playlists. Again, they can be searched. I'll show you that in a moment. And we also have a program exchange, which I'll show you in a moment. So back to the media here. The media, there's a menu on the media bar here, the media tab. It shows, you can click it, so it shows your particular uploads that you've done, the approved media, the unapproved media, and this only, the unapproved media is media that you as an administrator haven't approved. Again, permissions can be arranged so people that are uploading media can automatically approve their media if they're trusted, or if it's a new person on your staff, you can hold back that permission until you know how they work. But again, it'll show the unapproved media. And the archived media is media that's been deleted but hasn't been completely deleted out of the system. You can keep it in an archive if it's something that you're going to use on a semi-regular basis, but you don't want to have it in the regular media library. The media that we have here is mostly music. The music, we have episodes of programs, for instance, this Canada Land program. This is a regular thing that we download from these producers, and it shows the time here. This is 59:22. So I'll just give you a quick look here. So if I want to search for a certain piece of media, let's just be very standard here, and I'm just going to put in the word Beatles, and it'll give me everything that has the Beatles in it, including the title of it or the actual artist. And we can align, align them so under artist, title, or the amount of time. If I hit the more button, it gives me more information on the particular thing. So if you have a particular album that you want to look for, you can align them by album, by title. If you have the year, you can align them by the year. So all the Yellow Submarines with the Beatles. The time, so if you have a particular time to fill in your playlist and you want to put a Beatles song in, you can actually go by time. And these are all things that will be added when you upload your track. And they're all searchable, and I'll show you that in a moment. So that's just searching Beatles by title, by a simple search of anything that has Beatles, again, in the title or in the artist. The advanced search will give you different parameters. You can search by artist, by title, by album, by year, categories, which I'll show you in a moment. Country, if you know that a particular piece of music is from Afghanistan or the Barbados or Canada, again, this is information you would add it when the media is uploaded, or sometimes it's in the ID3 tag. You can search by that. Language, again, you can search by language. The genre, and the genres can be added or subtracted by administrators. There's a comment section in the media uploads. You can search by comments, or if you're looking for a particular track by time, you can put in the amount of seconds, and it'll search by that. And again, you have a bar here that says My Searches. So on your particular account, if you're searching for similar things on a daily basis, it will keep a list of searches that you've already done. I don't think anything's in here. Oh, there is. So right now, so I was looking for Halloween stuff recently, things that contain the word work, some Yukon music I was looking for, and I was looking for an album to see if we had called A Motown Christmas, getting ready for that season. So just to show you the we search for Beatles in the simple search, and this particular song, Yellow Submarine. I can go down and I can click the word edit, and I can go in and I can see all the parameters that I could search for. So the artist, the title, the album, the year, the category is music. If it was a image, I could create images. I could click image and it would be searchable by image, but this is a piece of music, so we've categorized it as music. If you have commercial ads, you can put them under the category of audio, video, or image. And again, this is for a new piece of media that you're adding. If it's a community event, a lecture, talk, or discussion, a news or weather segment, priority broadcast, PSAs in the three formats. If it's a show promotion for a particular show, you can add that. If it's a complete show, like I showed you the Canada Land show, that's a complete show. I would consider that a complete show. You would put it under that. And if it's a show segment, if it's a small segment that's been recorded to go in a show, it would be a show or a station ID, and we all know what those are. And these all will change the parameters of your music. So again, this is just a piece of music by the Beatles. It shows how it's laid out. The country's the United Kingdom, language, it's under classic rock. If you're the copyright owner of this particular piece of music, you can change it to yes. Of course, we're not. And again, this is where your media is approved, yes or no. And the status bar here, it just shows, this will show up in a public search of this particular track. If you have a particular track that's yours and you don't want anybody else to see it or be able to play it, you can under your account create it as a private track, and people won't be able to search for it or view it or use it. And again, include in dynamic selection, yes or no, and we'll get into the dynamic selection in a moment. So I'm just going to save that. We haven't changed anything. So that's the media tab or media library. I'm going to change that, refresh that. I'm just going to put a refresh on this. And and this will load back to the way it's set up here is it loads the latest track that was uploaded here, and it goes back in history this way. We can zoom up and down. And one feature I should show you here, your account settings for your account. It's kind of taking a step back. So you have a username that you use when you create an account. My name is Bill Polonsky. I'm the station manager here at CJUC. I can change my password. I can change my email. And here's what I want to show you. The search results per page. I have the maximum of 1,000. You can have a minimum of 5. I have 1,000, and it will show 1,000 search results on each page. I can change my language, and this is the to German, Estonian, French, Thai, and we have Chinese in there. And the themes are, this one is Tanzanite. I like the colors of this one. If you're vision impaired, you can change it to a higher or lower contrast, depending on your needs. And we also have a dyslexia-friendly font. Right now it's disabled. If you have trouble reading, you can change it to the dyslexia-friendly font, and it's a little easier to read for people with dyslexia. So there's a bit of accessibility that's put in there. Okay. So we have our media here. The formats that go to the administration, there's a navigation bar down here. I'm going to be hopping around here. There's this particular instance, we support a lot, all the formats. So in the audio formats, we support in audio, we support FLAC, MP3, MP4, Ogg Vorbis, and WAVE. And again, it depends on how big your server is and your internet bandwidth. So in Whitehorse here, where the bandwidth is a bit pricey, so we can make a smaller MP3 file. But if you're not worried about bandwidth, you can have full WAV format in your audio. In video, AVI, MPEG, Ogg, Windows Media, and Apple QuickTime. And these will upload and play in a television situation. And again, Open Broadcaster will run a radio, a television, or it will run signage with static images and music and things like that. And the image formats that are supported are JPEG, PNG, and scalable vector graphics. And I'll show you how you can create a scalable vector graphic within OpenBroadcaster in a moment. And this would be for creating a quick sign if you needed an announcement, or you can create your own graphics for standalone signage. And here you can also add categories and genres. So if I want to add a genre, I can name the genre. And again, this is for, this will suit audio, video, or pictures. So you can create your own genres. For instance, in music, we have rock and classical and jazz. You can create your own genres and add it to Open Broadcaster and save your media as those particular genres. We have a map here that shows alerts within Canada, and Open Broadcaster will show you, for instance, this is a Canadian map, and something's going on in Saskatchewan. These polygons are all generated through Palmer X, and if I click on it, it will give me an idea of what's going on with this particular alert. So it's a weather statement in effect. So this isn't a major alert, but it is telling you that we're now into winter in southern Saskatchewan, and there's particular things to look out for. And it shows you when this particular alert expires, where it originated from, Environment Canada, the area. So it's quite a large area of southern Saskatchewan. And I think these are probably all weather alerts. Yeah, weather alerts. Yeah, weather alert. So, yeah, so there's 5 centimeters of snow in southern Alberta. And that, I'm just going to zoom out a bit here. And you can show all of Canada. So in Thunder Bay, you probably have a weather alert there. Fog advisory. And these are just minor alerts. If there's a major alert, it will show you that also. And so that's the map up here in Hudson's Bay. A special weather statement. Not a major alert, but it does tell you the area and when the alert expires. These show you the different installations of OpenBroadcaster in the Yukon up here. So Whitehorse, CFET and Tagish. Let's zoom in on that a little bit. Whitehorse, Tagish, Haines Junction. Okay. And all right. So I'm going to zoom out there. Great. And again, this shows you the different symbols that may appear on the particular alerts, and the Canadian alerts, and then there's the American alerts. There's much more alerts for the United States. And this is a feature of OpenBroadcaster. Just jump right into uploading media. So we already have a lot of media in this particular library. I'm just going to show you a quick way. I just give you a demonstration how to upload media. So I would go down to the media tab, click upload media, and it asks me to select a file. So I'm going to go on my particular computer here. And I have a file in the music here. And it's a piece of blues. I'm going to upload it. And it's going to upload. And as it uploads, it shows you could fill in the artist name, title, album, year. This is all done automatically with an ID3 tag. Again, you would change it to music, country is the United States. There you go. You can add, this is blues. Blues. And as it uploads, it will fill in these things with the ID3 tag. I'm just going to move along because this is a quick demonstration. So this would be the media area. There's an ad manager, which is important if you are running ads. I can drag a piece of an ad that you get from your local business or an ad agency, and you can drop it into here. You can, it shows the current ads, the upcoming ads. You can schedule them to play for a certain time. So for instance, we just had an election in Canada. You could have, if and there might be certain parameters that the client wants for your ad. So it may play from one day to maybe 3 days from now, and you can say, okay, on Friday it's going to quit at a certain time, and it will automatically go from the current ad to the expired ad. It will also show upcoming ads that are going to be playing. So you can set your ads up in advance. I'll show you the program manager in a moment. The SVG editor, again, this is the editor for doing a quick static image pick a color here. So I can change, I can add an announcement, I can add symbols. It's like a little Photoshop, not quite as, I can add different things behind it. There we go. And I could save this as a SVG graphic. Again, this is just a quick demonstration, so I'm not that artistically inclined. So this would be saved as a piece of media up here that you'd be able to search and drop into a playlist later to show you your clients if you know something on special or an alert or anything you need to quickly put together for your particular signage needs. So there's a few things that, so as a radio station, there's three things you need. I'll show you the quick schedule here. This is our schedule at CJUC in Whitehorse. Runs 24/7. The blank spots right now are shows that haven't added this week so far. So we have a fellow at 9 o'clock that he hasn't put his show together and he hasn't uploaded it yet. But right now it shows you that we have 7 days a week, 24 hours a day we run. And these particular titles are all programs. So for instance, in Whitehorse Net right now, we're coming up to our UConn Spotlight. And if I, Wednesday here, so if I highlight, put the cursor over it, it shows the UConn Spotlight. It has a playlist number that it generates. It's my particular show, so it has my name on it. And it shows when and what day it's going to play, what time it's going to play, how long it's going to be. The duration is an hour. It was scheduled by me. And then it has a description. So UConn artist with the challenge of the UConn episode included in that. And if I go over to, I can show you that particular playlist. If I go up to playlist and I type in, it's called UConn Spotlight. So there we go. And I can look at that particular playlist. So again, it has the name, the description of it. I've created this playlist as a public playlist so people can see it, they could look at it. So if I was another user on this particular radio station, I could look at this, but because I don't own it, I can't change anything here. So this is our playlist. It's an hour long. It's actually a little bit over an hour, just in case there's I'll show you the dynamic selections and why it's a little longer than an hour here. So right now, when it's scheduled, the computer goes along and it says, sees this particular green segment, it's a station ID, and it will play, this is a dynamic selection, so it will play one of about 30 station IDs we have in at CJUC in Whitehorse. And and as station IDs are added, the computer or the program has the intelligence to add it to this particular dynamic selection. So as long as the dynamic selection is asks to play a station ID, anything that is a station ID will play. So it plays one station ID, then it plays unnamed. Another station ID, and then we have a dynamic selection of Haines Junction events. So these are events that happen in a community close to us called Haines Junction. We have an active radio person up there who does a lot of live events. So anything he adds to the computer will be caught by this particular dynamic selection and it will play one of them. Then I have some intro bits. And then I have dynamic selection challenge of the UConn. Now, if I click on this, it's going to open this. So it shows me that the selection is called challenge of the UConn, and it will play one of, I think we have over 600 challenges of the Yukon, so we'll play one of the 600. And again, if I wanted to play them all in a row, I can click all items. And if this was an image on a television system or some sort of video, if this was driving a video screen, you can have the amount of images within a particular category, and it shows the duration of the image. So this is just, so if it was an image, it would play for 5 seconds and then go to the next image. And again, I have this set up so it has station IDs, it will play, on this particular one, it will play 3 Yukon tracks. So these are tracks that are local music. I've put them in a genre called Yukon, and it will play 3 of those particular tracks in a row. And then it plays a station ID, some more Yukon tracks. I have some, it will play one track under sound effects of Yukon birds, which sounds kind of strange, but in the Yukon, when it's snowing out here in the winter, it's nice to hear what the summer sounds like. Again, and it goes along and along and along. And because this isn't it gives you for instance, this particular Yukon tracks, it says 3 tracks, and it's approximately 10 minutes and 44 seconds. That gives you an average of the track. And that's why I have the time going over a little bit, just in case it doesn't meet the hour. It might cut off on one of these promos or one of these lesser tracks down here. So that's, and you can set these up. I have this set up, I don't know when the last time actually, I could look into this here, look at the details. So I created this in 2009, this particular show, with these different segments, and I last updated it on the 30th. So I went in and I tweaked it a bit, but basically this show has remained similar since 2009. It's a popular show, and it's different every day because all these dynamic selections will play different tracks every day. So again, the Challenge of the Yukon, it will play one of about 600 Challenge of the Yukon episodes, which are about 15 minutes long. And the same with the Yukon tracks. If it plays 3, it will play 3 different tracks. And as new Yukon music is added to our particular database, it will add it to this dynamic selection. So you never actually have to go back in and say there's more tracks. It automatically has the intelligence to go out and say, okay, there's a new Yukon track. Let's include that in that particular selection. So again, we'll go back to the shows. So these are, and again, a lot of these segments are dynamic selection segments. The reggae show is dynamic, the rock show is dynamic. And as we're a volunteer organization, so as we get new volunteers and they can select their own time, we can add them in. So again, there's a person that hasn't put their show up for 9, another person that hasn't put up their show here for 4 o'clock on Friday, and other people, like last night, the Local French Association put in their show for November 3rd. And it's easy enough to, I'll just give you an example of here, how to add a playlist to the particular schedule here. We have, and again, as an administrator, I can do all this. Normally, if you are assigned a particular spot, you can only change that spot. So this person here can only change that particular spot. They can't say, I want to put my show here and delete this show. So it's controlled that way. But as an administrator, I'll just give you an example here. So I'm going to take my Yukon show. I know it's an hour long, and I know that on Thursday at 9 o'clock, there's a spot. So I'm just going to drop it into the schedule, and it's going to ask me where I want to put it. So it's going to be a manual input. It's a one time. It's going to be Thursday the 5th, and that was at 9 o'clock. So that's going to be 2100. And I'm going to hit done. And I know it's an hour long. And I'll hit save. and now it's populated in there. So there you go. So if I don't change it Thursday at 9 o'clock, I will, my Yukon show will play. I'm going to, so I'm going to go in there and I'm going to delete that particular show. Again, I'm just deleting that particular instance of the show. I'm not deleting the show. So I'm going to take that out and it's free again. Okay. So that's just a schedule. And again, if I go into permissions, I can show you, this is a schedule permissions. I'll just give you a quick show here. So we have a heavy metal show that this is the 9 o'clock show I just filled in. This particular guy, we have his show is 9 o'clock on Thursdays. So nobody else can actually add a show at 9 o'clock on Thursdays. Auditory Evolution is Wednesdays at 7. This particular gal has a show at this time. Nobody else can add their show to that time. I can do it because I'm an administrator. So again, so these are some of the shows that are kind of hardwired in that nobody else can change. We went through playlists. I'll just do a, so as we're already talking about playlists, I'll just show you the template for a playlist. So I'll just put in new playlist. The description would be my best tracks. Again, public or private. I keep everything public so everybody can see it. So this is a basic template, my new playlist. So for a playlist, you need tracks. So I'm going to say, okay, I like Magic Sam here. I'm going to take these tracks and I'm just going to drop them. I mean, 25 tracks over and I'm going to drop them in. And there's my playlist. And it's already going over an hour. So I go, ooh. Well, I like this particular song. I'm going to move it up here. But this one, I'm just going to delete. And these ones, I don't like that one. I don't like that one. Now it's under an hour. My Magic Sam show is going, oh, we should change the name to Magic Sam, maybe. And this is all, nothing is set until you save it. So Magic Sam hour. So because we're a radio station, we want our radio station to be promoted. We have it wired in here for, I can add a station ID, and again, it will play one of about 30 station IDs. And I want to add one at the end. And let's see, I'm going to add a couple more tracks just randomly. And again, I can search for tracks and I can drop them in and I can move them around as I see fit. So we're looking at 56. And I want to add another station ID about 15 minutes in and maybe another station ID there. So everybody, so we're promoting our radio station. Well, maybe I will like that song. Yeah, let's try that one. So it says it's 2 minutes and 58 seconds over. So if I go along here, I can see if there's one that's close to 2 minutes and 58 seconds. There's 2 minutes and 51 seconds, 2 minutes and 50 seconds. So this guy's going to go. And now I have a 1 second over. So if I move that down there, my station ID might be cut off by 1 second. But because these are dynamic selections, some of them are shorter, some of them are longer, chances are it's going to be a good timing. So there you go. Within about 2 minutes, I've created a Magic Sam Blues show, and I'm going to save it. And if I look under playlists here, and I go, so my Magic Sam hour came out at the beginning, and if I want to look at it again, I can hit edit and it'll open it up again. Anybody else that looks at these shows, it's going to show like this. It's going to show that. So they can't change anything. Nothing can be moved around. So It's just a representation of that. So I'm going to go back to my Magic Sam show, and I'll show you a dynamic playlist. So I've talked about the dynamic playlists in my Yukon show and how they work, and I'll show you how to make one quickly. So let's say Magic Sam, let's say I want to put in Howlin' Wolf. Let's see if there's any Howlin' Wolf songs. Oh, there's lots of Howlin' Wolf. We got Eric Clapton with Howlin' Wolf. Oh, see, the Black Keys have a song called Howlin' For You. So maybe you want to put in Howlin' Wolf specifically. That'll cut it down. And it shows, okay, so now I have 98 pieces of media that have Howlin' Wolf. And I want to mix it in with Magic Sam, but I don't know my Howlin' Wolf as much as I know my Magic Sam. And I just want to put in a dynamic selection with Howlin' Wolf to mix it up. So I've searched for my music here under, you can do it either under simple or again advanced. I want to be specific about which songs, but I've just put in Howlin' Wolf under simple. And it's come up with 98 pieces of media. So I've searched for it. I have my program open. If under here, it says add a dynamic selection. So I'm going to hit add a dynamic selection. Let's put a segment of Howlin' Wolf. Okay. And I want to add two songs by Howlin' Wolf. Boom. It gives me a segment here called Howlin' Wolf. Oh. I'm going to go back in here and I'm going to make sure his name is spelled correctly. There we go. There. So now this segment plays two tracks of these particular 98 tracks, and it's approximately 6 minutes and 56 seconds. So I'm going to add one here. I'm going to go, okay, maybe I'll add another one because I'm Howlin' Wolf, and three tracks. So again, this particular segment will play three tracks, and now it's approximately 10 minutes and 24 seconds. So it plays three tracks of these searched 98 tracks. And now if I go down to the bottom, my duration is 17 minutes over. So I can go in, I can maybe drop that one, and maybe drop that one, and drop that one. We're down to 7, and you can continue to do this to prune it. And again, you can move these around however you want. But that's how, if you do a show with a lot of dynamic selections, the show will play every day and it will play different songs every day. So it's a completely different program every day. And again, I showed you quickly how to do this. Again, you can move everything around. And once you're finished, you can save it. And that's it, saved, ready to go. I could drop that into a schedule, and it will play, I believe it's every 20 minutes. The schedule is updated with our server, so as long as I'm 20 minutes ahead of the hour, it will play. Very quick, very easy. If I look at the playlist, there's the Magic Sam Hour. That's the Magic Sam Hour. And again, I can go into the schedule and drop that in. Very easy. Schedules. We could set up priority broadcasts again. So if there's a, this is outside of any particular alerting module that we have. But if I wanted to set up something, I could drop in any track that was sent to us from an emergency measures organization or any track that we record and upload, and I could drop it into the schedule and set it up to play almost immediately. So I don't want to do it because let me just set up something here quickly. Okay, I'm just going to drop a track in. Now it's going to ask me for the name of the broadcast. I could play it in. So if I wanted this to play every 5 minutes, I would add. It's all in seconds, so it's 3,500 seconds. 350 seconds, sorry. So every 5 minutes, when to start it, what time to start it, what day to stop it, and what time in that day to stop it. So I could set that up really quickly if I had an emergency that I want to put on the air. I'm going to cancel that. So because we don't want to play ZZ Top every 5 minutes. So that's a quick feature for priority broadcasts. If you had a an Amber Alert, child's missing, you can immediately put something on the radio. So this is the administration panel, and again, I've been promising to show you this. I'll just go by the steps here. So this is all the different users on a particular application. Some of them have been there for a while. You can show when they last accessed it. Some people haven't accessed since 2012. We've given them accounts to sort of poke around and look at it. You can show when a particular person had created that particular account, the names and that, and you can go in as an administrator and email people and look at their information. Permissions matrix. This is very important. So as an administrator, you have permissions to do everything. A basic volunteer has on this particular instance doesn't have a lot of permissions. Hello? Not now. Okay. We also have basic volunteer, basic with priority. You can create a new group very easily by calling it something, adding the permissions that you want. So if you have a specific permissions for certain functions in your organization, say if you have just an ad person that wants to add ads and they have no business with any other media, you can add them to that. You can and again, it's all customizable. You can add as many as you need in your organization. Okay, so modules, as the different modules in OpenBroadcaster. So we have the map module, now playing, which is hooked up to our website. And so the API talks between OpenBroadcaster and our website, and anything that's updated on OpenBroadcaster is reflected on our website. OB2 to OB2, we can transfer media from one instance of OpenBroadcaster to another, depending on the permissions that you have for. You have to know the login information to the other instance, so it isn't something that can be done just randomly. We have the ad manager, program manager, SVG editor, different functions, and as different modules are available, they'll come here and you can install them. Media settings, I showed this before, the supported file formats. You can also add categories, you can add genres. It's very flexible depending on the needs of your particular installation. Media settings, player monitor. So I can go in here and I can see, I use this for particular tracks. If I'm looking for a particular artist, especially local music, and we're really hot on playing local music, so I can go in and put, so if I wanna look at particular artists, let's say I'm gonna go back in time to June 1st and it's gonna end today. And the artist is exactly Kim Beggs, and I'll add a filter, and I'll load that data, and it'll give me everything by Kim Beggs that has been played since June 1st. And there we go. So that's quite a bit for a local artist. Last few things here. Program settings. So this is for a program editor we have in here, and I'll show you that in a moment. That the program you can add different roles, different themes, and this is all for documenting what a particular piece of program has. So your producers, your editors, all that stuff can be added to a particular program. Player manager, this is just our particular instance of CJC. These are all the station IDs that are played on CJC. I don't really need to get into that for this particular demo. And then client settings, this is just the splash screen for OpenBroadcaster. And as things are added, or if you need to alert your users, you can add that to the OpenBroadcaster splash screen. We have the help tab here, and it has documentation, which will send you to our Wikipedia page, OpenBroadcaster Wikipedia. And it also has a tutorial that can run. Okay. I'm just going to check something here. I'm just going to put it on the permissions page here. You can see the different permissions. Okay, so the last tab we have here is the program exchange. So I'm just going to show you this. This is a new one. I'm going to click this open here. Again, this is this shows you this particular program Jam Live. This is produced out of Haines Junction, a local community here. And the producer is Dieter Gade, and shows all the episodes that he's added to this. So you can actually create a segment with this particular program and drop all your programs in here, and it'll play the latest episode as it comes up. And create a new one. It's just a matter of adding the particular title and summary. Another feature we can do is I could take my Magic Sam hour and I can, and it also works as a podcast assembler. So you saw all the tracks that I added to that particular playlist earlier. And if I drop it into this particular program exchange, it will create a podcast. And it takes out the station IDs and the segments that were randomized for Howling Wolf. It actually selects a couple tracks for Howling Wolf. So this gives you a fully fledged podcast of that particular thing. So it's one track. And if I hit build, it will build this. It'll take time, but it'll build this into a one-track podcast. So this is handy if you're building, if you have users on your particular installation that do complicated shows and they want to save it for later or distribute it to another person or post it on the internet or put it on a podcast site. This is pretty handy for this. This is a new feature we have with OpenBroadcaster. So that's OpenBroadcaster. Let me see. There's another thing here. A few last things here. So I'm going to let me see here. Again, I'll search for songs, and I'm just gonna look for a short one. So there's a particular thing here. It's a demo. I'm going to pull up to the media player, and it will load from the server, and it will play. It'll play that particular track. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to hear it. Perhaps not, because I have the sound on. Yeah. So if you're not sure what a particular track sounds like, or if you have a couple tracks and maybe one's a live track, you can do a quick listen to it there. Another thing on the, I want to look at the advanced search. I want to look at the media images. I can add, so everything that's an image in this particular database here will show. So I can look at that. I can look at the metadata for it. I can drag this particular image up to the here, and it gives me a preview of what it is. Right. So these are all images. If I go and I look for, let's see. Media type is video. I can add that, take out the image, search for that. And let's see what we got. And I can take that and bring that up there, and it'll play. Again, it's a lower res quality video of what. And again, it's video, so it's going to take a while to render here. There we go. This is we have a bunch of copyright-free theater ads on here, just for fun. So you can search for and preview any particular media that we have there. So that looks. Let me just see if there's one other thing here. We've added this. When I was looking for that image, I brought up this particular media. I could show extended details. And again, this adds producer and recording date. And this is the same for music tracks. So this is important for in Canada, especially if you want to add the Canadian content. You can add actual maple content. So the music, artist, performance, or lyrics. And as you add them, it will show the particular parts of the this is a symbol for Canadian music, and so you can show the particular parts of the music that are Canadian, and different licenses. If the content advisory, if it's profanity, violence, or substance abuse, nudity, sexual content, these can all be tagged, and so they don't get played at improper times. And again, you can add different things to this. Credits, the different roles, sponsors, composers, hosts, add the name. If it's a If it's a one-off recording, you can actually add where it was recorded, recording date, track lists, and all this information that that will be added to the track when you save it. So it's all information that becomes part of the track, and it can be, so there you go. So let me see here if there's anything else. I think that's a pretty thorough overall look at Open Broadcaster. Again, if there's any questions or comments, you can get a hold of me. My name is Bill Polonsky. I'm the station manager at CJC. I'm also a trainer at Open Broadcaster, and my email is bill@openbroadcaster.com. And you can ask me any questions, and I'll get right back to you. And if you want to see this again, I think we're going to have it in a YouTube format, and we'll edit out all the troubles at the beginning, and hopefully you can view it again. And again, any questions, get a hold of me, bill@openbroadcaster.com. Please visit our website at openbroadcaster.com. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed this, and we'll talk to you again.